Hi, my name is Adi Kapash. I'm from Chanakya National University and presently I'm an intern at Lex Clayton Company. In this video, we'll be talking about Protection of Children from Sexual Offences Act 2012 and basically the amendment that was brought in this act in the year of 2019. So starting from the context, which is the Union Cabinet had approved in 2019 for amendments in the POCSO Act, and the key changes that were proposed were that it will make punishment more stringent for committing sexual crimes against children, including death penalty. It includes provision of death penalty in cases of sexual offences against children. The amendments also provide for fines and imprisonments to curb child pornography. And amendments are also to protect children from sexual offences in times of natural calamities and in situations where children are administered in any way, any hormone or any chemical substance to attain early sexual maturity for the purpose of penetrative sexual assault. And these amendments were passed by the Parliament, and the major impact that it had on the act as well as its implementation was the amendment was expected to discourage the trend of sexual abuse and the trading of child pornography by acting as a deterrent due to strong punishments for such offences. Secondly, it intended to provide interest of vulnerable children in time of distress, and this ensures their safety and dignity. Thirdly, the amendment was aimed to establish clarity regarding the aspects of child abuse and child pornography. Now, it was formulated in order to effectively address sexual abuse and sexual exploitation of children. Now, there were different roles that were held by the police, by the safeguards, and different people. According to the amendments, according to the act, the role of the police was, the act cast the police in the role of child prosecutors during the investigative process. Thus, the police personnel receiving a report of sexual abuse of a child are given the responsibility of making urgent arrangements for the care and protection of the child, and such as like obtaining emergency medical treatment for the child and contacting the child welfare committee and taking the right paths to prevent the child from any further abuse or offence. The act further makes provisions for avoiding re-victimization of the child at the hands of the judicial system, because the entire process of complaining and then going through a trial and the judgment, that is anyway a burdensome issue for an adult, and it will be understood that it can be more problematic and more negatively impacting issue for a child. Hence, the act has had made provisions that makes it a little easier. It provides for special courts that conduct the trial in camera, which means in the absence of the child, you don't have like. The identity of the child does not need to be shown, and without revealing the identity of the child in any manner, that it's a child-friendly atmosphere in the courts, in the special courts. The mandatory reporting was also given in the Act. The Act also provides a mandatory reporting of the sexual offences. This casts a legal duty upon a person that if they come across any situation where they come across knowledge that somebody has abused a child, any crime has been committed, sexual crime has been committed against a child, then it's the duty of that individual to report. And the Act made it mandatory, and if he failed to do so, he may be punished with imprisonment for 6 years or fine. Now, the definition that was given in the Act is that Act defines a child as any person below 18 years of age. It defines different forms of sexual abuse, including penetrative and non-penetrative assault, as well as sexual harassment and pornography. It deems a sexual assault to be aggravated under certain circumstances, such as when the abused child is mentally ill or when the abuse is committed by the person in a position of trust or authority, like a family member, police officer, teacher or doctor. So this is the definition given for the child, and basically the idea behind the entire act to protect is to protect children from these any kind of sexual abuse, and if unfortunately offense happens, yeah, the act provides stringent punishments to those people, hence this having a deterrent effect on the society and on these abusers. So if you want more information, you can go and study the POCSO Act 2012 along with the amendments that were made in 2019.